in life, we have the right to speak the truth about, well, real-time relationships. When I talk about this, I am inspired by, of course, someone I really love. But that person was pretty good at building relationships to a point, but really struggled at having in-depth relationships, that I can tell you. What I've discovered about people in life is that they like to play I'm in power over you. So the Muslim men that don't actually belong here are plowing around the community, simply taking a walk, which might be something marvelous they would do back home, but my question is, what are you doing here? Are you a law professor and you're just acting like you don't belong here? Are you a foreigner who's come over to stay around his children and you really don't belong here? Or is anyone at all in Homeland Security paying attention? You see, when we don't pay attention to the truth of life, we don't get ahead in life. And what I've been experiencing since I've gotten here is a constant haranguement, a constant harassment by not only white men in the maintenance companies of apartment complexes and other places, probably spawned and spurted out and gossiped about by one man in the bankier company who's got white hair and always seems to show up when I play myself down in the early mornings of the hour to purchase some food at my typical vending spot. But openly what I'm talking about is mobbing techniques. Mobbing technique says, I'm going to ping you. I'm going to put something on you or on your person or on your baggage that allows me to follow you. Or maybe if I'm an asshole in the police force, I'm going to actually pellet you like you're a dog, some inhumane thing, so that I can always be in power over you. What I get tired with is the players of the white boys today who are literally living on high on the hog with their parents' funds. I highly doubt that these young men have made $24,000 to buy the trucks that they're driving. I highly doubt that they started saving as a child from age 5 for that car. Now, it's true and it's marvelous that some parents do teach their children how to scrimp and save all their life to plan for that adulthood, and those parents are marvelous. But when we lie to ourselves about the rights we have over other people, when we pretend that we have power over people, when we pretend and presume that we have a relationship with someone, we've just lied to ourselves. I have a handful of frat boys walking up to me simply saying, have a good night. And I look at them going, I'm not talking to you. I'm not even looking at you. And you're haranguing me with this comment as if we've got a relationship here. And what I see is the deceiver of Satan interfering with people here. What I'd like to talk about, of course, in my life is not what I'm experiencing as a homeless person. What I'd like to really talk about is where I'm going in my job in political consulting, but that's kind of hard to say because people are taking my content and they are actually using my suggestions. But maybe they got other people advising them the same thing, or maybe their advisors have pulled off the marvelous thing of pretending that they had that idea all on their own. In life, we know that people like to buy ideas from other people, not at all. But in the world of marketing, in the world of creative arts, in the world of intellectual property rights, we have the right to sell our ideas. When we sell our ideas to a car company, when we sell an idea to a baggage company, when we sell our ideas in full, we have the right to access and benefit those things. But the liars of a community will not do their rightful thing. They will lie, steal, and cheat people out of their intellectual property, taking things off their thumb drives, taking things off their computers, interfering with its functions, and they really don't have the lawful right by any law in America or any law around the world to do that. The Universal Declaration of Human Rights actually has a clause, or used to, at least as it was shown online, to have a technology clause that basically says, you don't have the right to impede my right to look up and research things that are right for me.